Hello, this is Gene. This is Sunday before the big games today. I don't know who I'm actually going to win. I just hope that New England doesn't win. So the other three teams, I don't really care whatever commentation that would be. Maybe Kansas City versus the Saints or LA, I don't really care. I just don't want New England to get to the Super Bowl again. But anyway, I'm trying not to be very upset, not be so emotional, but I'm just so tired of our society being so anti-white, and especially anti-young white males. Those who know, it's all over the news about this supposed harassment of a Native American in Washington, D.C., when kids that were from a Christian or a Catholic school were there for pro-life march, and they were doing what they were doing, just waiting for the bus to come along. Chanting their school name, and then this guy came over, this advocate for the Native Americans, which is fine. I don't care that he does it. And then he got in their face and started doing the thing with the drum and all that. And people at first, they just went out and crucified these kids online. And now some of them are coming back and saying, "Oh, after looking at it from different angles," but still, the mainstream media is just pushing this area that these kids were harassing this Native American, and their school is basically saying they might suspend some of these kids. First and foremost, these kids did nothing wrong, and I'm getting sick and tired of the mainstream media to vilify white kids, especially boys, all the damn time. You wonder why we have so many young men killing themselves, because the whole society is saying they're the problem, and this is another instance of this. A couple of them actually reached out to guys who are on Twitter that have a following and said that, this is now everybody's coming after us right now, based on a video that only showed a little bit of the time. But really, what they showed was a man standing there doing this banging this thing to a boy who just didn't do anything, just looked at him. And this is now called harassment. Now, after all this, this guy, this Native American, try to say that they came toward him and were harassing him, and that he was fearful for his life. Well, there's hundreds of videos from cell phones on the internet right now, and we know that he's the one who started all this stuff, and there was never any threat of violence on either side. They got upset because the boys were wearing a MAGA hat. And people, I mean, this is why so many people get black-pilled, because we know where our future is going right now. Because you continually do this to a kid, then he'll fall off, or he won't be involved, and he won't be involved because he knows he might get in trouble for saying something that's a little different. Those kids went to the pro-life march to support life and was wearing a MAGA hat. And there are people online saying just because of them wearing that hat that they were the offended the person that was being offensive. That it's problematic to wear a book or a hat that says "Make America Great." Stand back and listen to what that means. When you say that you want this country to be great again, that's a bad thing. It's like, because these people think that that means we want to get rid of all black people and all Native Americans and Hispanic people and all that bullshit. That's not what we want to do. We want this country to be about what it's supposed to be about. This is going to be a very small video. I'm not going to go rambling on because I think most people who watch this channel understand this. But we're seeing it right in our face every day. And people are, I said the other day, what event is going to wake up people like me in the United States? I don't think this is it. But there are a lot of people that have taken their, have get, took their foot off the gas on this. Even though at first they called it despicable by watching a 20-second video of the boy looking at the man, that was despicable. That I guess you're supposed to da up, bow down to Native Americans. And the people that allow this continues to goes on, and a lot of them are fucking conservatives, Shapiro said something about it. All these other fuckers that come out and they say they're not SJWs and they're all fucking the same thing and they're all that blue check mark and they're all fucking Jews. And I'm sick and tired of this being the same fucking people all the time. It doesn't matter what side of the aisle they're on. They say the same shit because they want to push this narrative that white people are bad, especially young conservative white men and boys. I'm sick and tired of this. So yesterday somebody on Twitter said something about that we have to, our mescalinity is gone. I responded to this person. I said, look, I'm here. I'm trying to inform people, guys younger than me, boys younger than me, that says it's okay to be white, okay? And it's also okay to have masculine features. Look, I was probably a beta my entire life. Excuse me. But compared to what we have right now, I'm clearly an alpha. And I'm trying to continually help our kids, our boys, to understand what their role is in this country as fathers or whatever. It's all important. And they're like, okay, they're good that somebody's doing about it. I said, this is my last great task in my life. I mean, I served my country. I had kids. Hopefully they'll have kids as well to have my line continue on. And I've explained to them how important it is about heritage, about being whatever you are. If you're a female, I think it's more important to be this. If you're a man, you should be doing this, but you should have the ability to do all this stuff and not just look at the ideology that we don't listen to me because I say, listen to the conservative side, or don't listen to me because I used to be a Democrat. Find out for yourself and realize what's being fair for you. If somebody says that, if a black person said that, would he be in trouble for it? Because in that in same area, there were black people just calling these kids fags. Nobody cares about that because they're part of that privileged class of being victims in this country. They're right up there at the top. And it gets me so aggregated that so many people are not waking up when it's seeing something like this. They just say, oh, they're just boys. They don't really give a shit. And especially if they're white, they really don't give a shit because just by the fact they were born white and they're male, they have privilege anyway. So we shouldn't care what happens to them. Like, oh, they only get toxed, or only they might get suspended for a couple days. And these kids will have trouble getting to college after this. Whereas guys like that dumbass down in Parkland who didn't have a high grade point average and didn't have a great SAT is going to Harvard because he is against guns, whatever his guy's name is. The guy would have never got into any of these universities until he became an activist against guns because they're so... Everybody's so leftist right now, and I said it years ago, that in the 80s, we won the PC battle, because there was a part in this country that was starting to stop about free speech. It was we're getting to that head again, and we stopped it from happening. But those people that said they bunkered in, and they become the professors at the universities, because they were students at that time, and they stayed there and became the professors. They've been there for 20 or 30 years, and they've been indoctrinating all the kids since then. So everybody on the left, everybody on the campus now are all leftists. And back then in the 80s, it was probably about between two or three liberals to one conservative. Still more than it should be, but it was that. It's now 25 to 1. It's changed so much in 30 fucking years, and they've indoctrinated our kids, and it takes them till they're 40 or 50 to get past that indoctrination. Not all of them do, but some do. With what we've seen, there would probably everybody should be Democrats. But they have this idea that everything that you're based on how you're born, the color of your skin, and that it puts you on your hierarchy of where you're going to be and whether you have privilege or power or whatever. And people just assume that this is something true. Now, as a person, I advocate for people like me, okay? You can call me racist for doing it. Every other group is allowed to do it. I'm going to do it, but I don't play the game of any identity politics. If you're good enough to do the job and you're citizens of this country, I have no problem with you getting a job over me if you're better than me. I don't have any issue with that. I do have a problem having people come from the third world and rising rages down for people who don't have great skills and can't get the great jobs. And the fact that they bring other things as well, and then we have to support them. Those who actually work end up using their taxes to support people here that don't work. That's more the current conservative side of me. It's at some point we are going to wake up. And I see the frustration online. And I think that this is another thing. After the whole BuzzFeed article that was basically told that it was not accurate, and then the next day we're having this, and immediately all these blue check marks come out saying how despicable these boys were being. Well, I don't, if they were there doing the chant and they said build the wall, which they didn't do, this is what this motherfucker said they said. It's on every video. They didn't say it. They were chanting their own school thing. A couple of them did do the Chamacock thing, but that's a part of pulp culture right now. I'm a Florida State fan. They do it there. The Braves do it. Tonight, the Kansas City Chiefs will do it. But they were basically all part of it together. This guy was playing his drums. And what was he actually doing? He was doing a war chant. What? And then you heard people in the background, other Native Americans, saying, go back to Europe. I mean, okay, could we have said something like that? Do you go back on the reservations, you fucking Indians? I mean, it's gotten so far off the wagon wheel. It's everywhere out there. And, oh man, I got to stop. Because when I get upset like this, I can't make any forms of my opinions because of my stroke. So I'm just going to leave it right there. You guys have a good day. Hopefully there'll be some good games today. And hopefully New England won't win. So thank you for watching. And please, if you see something like this, if you see this type of a scenario happening, support these kids. Call their school. Tell them that you're going to boycott them if they try to suspend these kids. Go to the local TV stations if you live in that area, and just be supportive for these kids, because it's just the wrong way. These guys were doing the right thing. They were protesting abortion, which is one of the worst things that we have in the United States. And these are good kids. Anyway, thank you for watching, and we'll talk to you guys later. Bye.